Now I'm going to show you how to plant a native plant. The first thing to remember is you do not want to dig the hole too deep. You want to dig the hole slightly less deep than the soil that's in the container. So for this baby St. Catherine's lace buckwheat, the soil in the container is this high. So I'm going to dig a hole slightly less deep, only that high in total. Then the next step is you want to dig it twice as wide as the container. And you want to sort of score the sides of the hole so that the roots can grab hold. You do not want to make a smooth-sided hole. It's looking just as if the plant crown is sitting slightly higher than the soil level. That's perfect to make a little plant island with a moat around it and then a berm around the moat to keep the water in. I'm going to pour in 3 gallons of water and wait for it to completely drain out before I plant the plant. And then you also want to water the plant in the pot thoroughly before you plant it as well. Here we are a half an hour later with the hole that we filled with water. It has completely drained, so we know that we have fast draining soil and we can plant anything, either a clay adapted plant or a plant that is adapted to fast draining soil. What you want to do is gently put your fingers like this around the stem of the plant and turn it upside down and then slip the pot off of the plant roots. Now, you can see all of these plant roots that are here on the edge. You don't want to be rough with it. Instead, you want to just gently break it apart so that the roots will spread out into the soil of the hole. So I'm just gently massaging the roots, gently breaking them up. And with most plants, you can do this. There are certain plants that will rebel if you do it and die, like Motilleja poppy. You definitely don't want to do it with Motilleja poppy and island bush poppy, but with most plants, it's just fine to be very gentle. So now I take my other hand, I flip it over, and now I set it in the hole. And I start to fill in the soil, patting it down with my knuckles to get out any air pockets. I'm making the plant be a little plant island surrounded by a moat. And now I make a berm of soil all around the moat to keep the water in. Now we'll do the test. We'll pour the water in. And if I've planted this properly, the plant should be on a little bit of an island sitting above the water that's in the moat. I think another quarter inch higher would have been better, just to raise that plant island up just a bit so that there was definitely no water around the stem. But this is what you want to do. Dig the hole slightly less deep than the soil in the container, twice as wide, fill it with water, let the water drain, water the plant in the pot before you plant it, and then plant, and then water once again.